Hi, I'm Brick Aramello with BrickAramello.com, and in this video, I'm gonna color grade footage I shot with the Osmo Pocket in D-Cinelike mode. And I'm gonna show you how I do that in Premiere Pro. And then I'm gonna show you how that footage looks next to the normal shot footage and footage that I didn't color grade in D-Cinelike. So let's get right into our computer and get started. So now we're in Premiere Pro, and the image I have right here is this painting on a wall. I liked it because there's all these different colors. And over here in the upper right hand corner, you can see this building in the background. Very dull, very plain, just some grays, maybe a little beige tone right there, silver, blacks. So it has a lot of different colors in it, so I thought it'd be a good one to color correct. Basically what I do is adjust the white balance and some of the tones in order to color correct it. And then I go into a proper color grading, which adding all these things like curves, color wheels, etc. So for this image, you can see the final image, it looks like this, all right? Now you may say, oh, I don't like that, that's way too saturated. I wanted to color grade it this way or change it this way. It's all subjective. So you can do it how you wanna do it. This is how I liked it. There's a million ways you can do it. I'm just gonna show you the way I did it. What I did was I started with the temperature and I made it a little warmer, brought it to the right, 17.2. So I made it much warmer in tone, because if you notice, it's kind of cool in tone right there. So I made it a little warmer. I didn't adjust the greenish tones or the magenta tones. I just left the tint alone. And then I went on to the exposure. Now for the exposure, I noticed it was a little underexposed. If you look over here, you can see it's a little underexposed. So I brought that up to 0.5. And you know, my bad, I didn't properly expose the image. It's good to get that right in camera because you really don't want to mess around with that. I could have also adjusted the exposure down here with my curves. I could have just taken this midpoint and brought it up, but I didn't do that. I just did it here because it was a little simpler to do. And then I adjust my contrast. Now, you can adjust your contrast right here. I brought it up to 55, or you can go to your curves. You can bring the shadows down, or you're making the shadows darker, and then you're making the highlights brighter. Okay, so you bring that little curve up this way. And I just did it ever so slightly. So I added, after the fact, I added even a little more contrast, but initially I added 55, which is quite a bit of contrast because you notice the initial image is very flat, so it needs some contrast to it. So I added a bunch of contrast right there. And I also added a bunch of highlights. So I noticed around the eyes, it was kind of dull. It didn't have much of a pop. And I noticed with this painting, the girl's eyes are really the focal point. To me, her eyes, any type of portrait, you want to be drawn to the eyes. So that's the most important part, other than the colors, which are really tremendous in this painting. So what I did was I brought the highlights up to 14.8. to emphasize her eyes right there, especially since it's white, it's gonna be the highlights. So I brought that up. And then the shadows, I already had adjusted the contrast so much, so I just brought that down -1, all right? Just added a little more darkness to the shadows. And then I didn't really adjust the whites or the blacks, left those alone. I noticed for the saturation, it was very flat. So what I did was I added, as you can see right here, it was very flat, right? It needs more color to it, more saturation. I went all the way up to 107. Now, that might be a little too much. Maybe I overdid it. Maybe I could have gone down to like 105. Maybe if I just left it where it was initially. Even that looks okay. Like maybe you like more of a cinematic look. You don't like so much saturation. But, you know, the colors are really should be emphasized in this. So I brought it up to 107. I think I like that a little more. Then I went to the creative. Now in the creative, I sharpened it a little bit. Now this is gonna be 0. It depends what you want. I didn't wanna sharpen it too much because this is a more artistic looking piece. Anything where you want a cinematic look, you don't wanna sharpen it too much, all right? I think a lot of people make that mistake. They sharpen it too much. So I just added 10. I probably could have gone a little more, but I just left it at 10. Okay, then the vibrance. The vibrance adds even more like color to it, a little more, makes it kind of pop out a little more saturated. So I added 15. I felt like I could have gone 20 or 25, but I felt like that was a little too much. All right, I didn't want to make it look too kind of wacky, too artificial. I wanted to make it kind of tastefully done, but still kind of pop out a lot. So I did 15 for that. All right, now we move down to the shadow tint and the highlight tint. For films, a lot of times you'll see people do this. So this is what I did, and it just seemed right after I did it. So I took the shadow tint and I moved it more to the blue, and I took the highlight tint and I moved it more towards the orange, okay? So if you move the shadows to blue and the highlights to orange, you're gonna get a more cinematic film type of look. They call it the Hollywood look, but you can call it whatever you want. I think it looked good with this because we do see a lot of oranges over here. We see the blues everywhere as well. So I felt like it fit well with this image, and also it's a person's face. So it works really well with skin tones and people's portraits, people's faces. Even though this isn't a real person, I still feel like it fit to do that. So I adjusted it ever so slightly. You don't wanna do it too much, and I just made it ever so slightly. So that's what I did. And then we're gonna go to curves. As I said before, I adjusted, added a little more contrast, brought the shadows down, the highlights up. You don't wanna go crazy. At first, you should just adjust it ever so slightly and then see how it looks, and then you can change it later. Maybe add a little more if you don't like it. And then you can keep going back and forth. So, you know, I look at it and then I go forth to the original if you want, just to see how much it changed. So that's one thing I do when I do color correction and color grading. And then I move now to the color wheel. So we're well into the color grading part of this tutorial, this video. Even this kind of stuff where you're adding the shadow tint and highlight tint, to me, this is more color grading than color correction. But whatever you want to call it, we're adding different colors and tones, and we're manipulating the image to make it look the way we want it to look, okay? So it's always a personal thing. So again, don't say, oh, what are you doing? I would never do that. Okay, you don't have to do it my way. I'm just showing you the way I did it, okay? But there's a million ways you could do it. So we go over here for the shadows. You know this is blue. And this is blue, that means I changed it. This is white right here for the midtones. So since this was a very flat image, there wasn't a lot of contrast to it, I didn't really need to adjust the midtones. The midtones were fine, but I noticed that the shadows needed a little to be brought down even more, and the highlights brought up ever so slightly. So that also added a little more contrast. So I did it here in the color wheel. I did it with the curves, and I also did it with the contrast initially. So all three of those things really made the image pop out more, made the colors more vibrant, and made the highlights brighter and the shadows darker. So those three things can help, and those are three ways to do it. The secondary temperature right here, I didn't do any of that. And the vignetting, I didn't want to add any vignetting. I liked it the way it was. And that's what I did. Okay, so you can see back original and then color graded. Obviously, it's like night and day. It's completely different. So that's how I did this image. You can do it sort of however you want, but this is what I did. Now I'm going to show you a comparison of all three of them. So I'm going to show you normal mode, I'm going to show you D-Cinelike, and then I'm also going to show you the color graded so that you can see whether you want to shoot in normal mode or if you prefer to put in the extra effort to shoot in D-Cinelike and then color grade it. So we're going to get into it right now. We'll be right back. All right, I hope that video was helpful. Obviously, color grading is very subjective, so you can do it in your own particular way, but I showed you how I do it. If you did enjoy this video, press that like button. And if you wanna see the video that I made right after DJI released the D-Cinelike mode, comparing D-Cinelike to the normal mode, you can look at that over there. All right guys, before I go, as always, I appreciate if you subscribe to this channel. It helps me grow my channel to make more videos about the Osmo Pocket, other DJI products. And before I go, remember, siempre pa'lante, nunca pa'tras.